Alcohol is also a drug. Alcohol, cardiomyopathy kills more people than heart attack kills. Does the government take any action? And alcohol is one of the important causes of cancer along with tobacco. Now, does anyone go near tobacco? Tobacco industry is very powerful. If we can ban tobacco growth in this world and we can ban alcohol, 75% of the cancers are gone. Do we want cancer to go? No. Cancer industry is a big industry. We don't want to break our own rice bowl. We did an audit recently of two slots of time, 40 years, 1900 to 1940, 1950 to 1990. Now, 1900 to 1940, we didn't have any treatment for cancer. The treatment was tender, loving care and good food. 1950, 1990, we had so many treatments. We had tablets, we had chemotherapy, we had surgery. But now, the per capita death of people who come to the hospital and go home, horizontal or vertical, has become worse in the second half. Today, do you know what has spoiled medicine? Money. It's become a big industry today. It shows the basic defect in our thinking. So chemotherapy, radiation, mutilative surgery are okay. They may look very good because of the advertisement, but they're really, in fact, they don't do any good. And now we have known that use of chemotherapy aids and abets the second cancer. So in the bargain, we have killed more people by our treatment than saved. Now what will a parent whose child is destroyed, child is killed? It may not be 100%. Even 1%, that 1% in statistics means nothing. For that one family, one child lost is 100%. We frighten people about cancer. We say, oh, your father had cancer, you will get cancer. And that fear itself kills and the cancer comes up. In fact, even if your father and mother both had cancers, you need not have cancer because genes have no role now to play in evolution. Evolution is environmental. And the most important part of human environment is human mind. And human mind is not in the brain. Human mind is a consciousness. It's all over the body and all over the place. And if you don't control your mind to be a very tranquil, compassionate, hardworking mind, you will probably, you are heir to all diseases. Recent studies in Amazon forest deep down showed there are aboriginal races without even clothes who live up to 100 years and they get their treatment from the herbs around them. They know what to take. They have the intuition. We have suppressed our intuition by the Western education and brought up what is called intellect. In 1802, there was this romantic English poet called William Wordsworth. He wrote a beautiful poem. World is too much with us, late and soon. Getting and spending, we seem to waste our powers. Little do we see in nature that is ours. You were asking about marijuana. It's in nature. Nature knows how to cure, how not to cure. The industry is putting a lot of pressure. Especially the drug industry is putting a lot of pressure on these herbal treatments for any disease, including cannabis. And cannabis is said to be a drug used as. Alcohol is also a drug. Alcoholic cardiomyopathy kills more people than heart attack kills. Does the government take any action? And alcohol is one of the important causes of cancer along with tobacco. Now, does anyone go near tobacco? Tobacco industry is very powerful. If we can ban tobacco growth in this world and we can ban alcohol, 75% of the cancers are gone. Do we want cancer to go? No. Cancer industry is a big industry. We don't want to break our own rice bowl. I'll give you a very simple example. If cancer can be screened early, it should be screened probably when it started, which is about 10 or 15 years before the real cancer comes as a clinical cancer. But the day the cell becomes a cancerous cell or mutates to become a rogue cell, the cancer starts. And this cell travels all over the body and it can get deposited anywhere. And then it may take 10 years, 15 years, 20 years for the main cancer to come up somewhere. Maybe in the breast, maybe in the stomach. By the time you detect it very early, the seedlings have gone all over the body. So after you remove the cancer, treat it, another cancer crops up somewhere else. So we want more cancers. That's why we say screen cancer so that now we can treat more people. Screening is a big industry. Did you know that? Screening is the biggest industry because in screening, you have 6.2 billion people. In treating patients, you have only a few million on a given day. Everybody is not ill. But everybody in the world can be scanned. Every child born can be vaccinated. So these are the two big industries. Scanning industry and vaccine industry. And this is owned by the richest people in this world. Karl Popper, a great thinker in the 50s, said, knowledge advances not by repeating known things, but by refuting false dogmas. There are so many false dogmas in the field of medical science, so-called Western medical science, that these things need to be demolished. To do that, you have to do refutative research. What we do is, we simply follow the Western system, RCT studies. Randomized control studies have now been proved to be unscientific. And randomized control studies are not even accounted for in the West now. They want what is called N for one study, single patient studies and collective study, and which we do in our system without any problem. So we don't want to teach the truth. Learning and teaching must be everyday learning. Things change every day. That's why I have coined a new word, 21st century illiterates. Most of us are 21st century illiterates. Today, illiterate doesn't mean not knowing how to read and write. A illiterate today is one who cannot unlearn the wrong things he has learned and relearn the right things. But we have banned marijuana. Even medicinal marijuana we have banned. We have not allowed anybody to try that. But there are still people using it on the side, you know, without the governments and the authorities notice. And they do well. All these are not being assessed properly, scientifically, if you want to use that word, science. Today we have a government, thanks to our Prime Minister, which can respond to our requests. Only thing is, it must reach them. The present system is such that they are all sort of, you know, walled off. You can't reach the thinkers. Very few thinkers in India. And if we can convince the government, well, let's have a study. Let's have a prospective study instead of having all these rubbish studies. We want to show some short studies funded by the industry saying that this has helped, that has helped. But the same study repeated, replicated without money from the funding agency has shown nothing has happened. One of the cancer specialists, a very important cancer specialist, who is a Regius Professor of Medicine in Oxford, wrote a book, The Science of Medicine and Its Quiet Art. His name is David Weatherall. And David is a cancer specialist himself, and David writes one sentence I quote from his book. The way we treat cancer patients today with all these mutilative things reminds me of the way our ancestors used to brand every illness from common cold to cancer with red hot iron. And our future generation will never forgive us for the sin that we are committing for cancer patients today.